In that tutorial, you are going to learn how to create your own custom system keyboard on Android with Android Studio. We are going to create a custom system keyboard that could be used in any application that a user has installed on his phone. The first thing to make is to create the layout files for our custom keyboard. First, we create the keyboard view.xml file under the resources layout directory in our Android application. This view is like a container that will hold our keyboard. In this example, there is only one keyboard, but you could add other keyboards and swap them in and out of this keyboard view. Note here that we choose to set a specific background for our keyboard based on the primary color of our material design theme. Furthermore, we align the keyboard view to the bottom of the screen. Then we are creating the keypreview.xml layout file under resources layout. The keypreview is a layout that pops up when you press a keyboard key. It just shows what key you are pressing in case your big fat finger are covering it. This is not a multiple choice pop-up. For that, should you check out the candidate view in the developer documentation. We define a white background and the text color will be based on the primary color. The text size is set to 30 SP. Now we need to create some supporting XML files. Choose to create an XML folder in the resources folder. Then we add first a numberpad.xml file. It is the interesting part of the tutorial because with this file, we are going to define the content of our keyboard. Our keyboard will be pretty simple. We are just going to display numbers and both buttons at the bottom, one to delete and another named Enter to let the user to return on the next line. The first row of our keyboard will be for the numbers 1 to 5, from left to right. The second row will be used for the numbers 6 to 9 and the zero number from left to right. And finally, the third row will be used for the delete and enter buttons. The delete button will be on the left and the enter button on the right. Then we create a method.xml file under the resources XML directory. This file tells the system the input method subtypes that are available. Here we are just including a minimal version. Now we can write the Java code to handle k-input. We create Java class that extends the input method service standard class from the SDK. All the logic of our keyboard is located here. We implement also the onKeyboard action listener interface. This class handles input received from the keyboard and sends it on to whatever view is receiving it, and edit text for example. So we implement the methods. We override the onCreateInputView method. In this method, we get the keyboard view and we add our keyboard layout to it. Then we install the keyboard action listener to the keyboard view instance. In the onKeyCallback method, we manage the key codes entered. First, we get the current input connection. We continue to work on it if the input connection is not new. We have a specific case to manage with the delayed key code entered by the user. We try to get the selected text. From the input connection. If there is no selection, we just delete previous character by calling the delete surrounding text method of the input connection. Otherwise, we delete the selection by calling the commit text with no characters to display. In the default case, we have just to cast in char the primary code received and we commit it on the input connection. The input connection is what is used to send input to another view like an edit text, like said previously. OK. Now it's time to update our Android manifest to register our own custom system keyboard. To register the custom keyboard as a system keyboard, we need to add a service section to our Android manifest file. We put it in the application section after activity. Don't forget to add the permission, bind input method for the service, and the correct intent filter with the action name android.view.input method. We also need to enter the metadata by pointing to our method.xml file in the XML resource folder. To try our system keyboard, we need to add an edit text to the layout of our main activity to show our custom keyboard in action. Okay, the edit text is here. Send the red in the screen. Okay, now we can run our application to test our custom keyboard, our custom system keyboard. Okay, it can take some time. The Gradle build can take some time. The APK is installing. The activity is launched. Click on the edit text. Then click on the left button, then other keyboard. We need to enable our custom system keyboard. Okay, my keyboard is there. We enable it. Okay. Okay. Click on the edit text. Go on the left button. On the right button, sorry. And choose my keyboard. Okay, our custom system keyboard works great. You can see the number from 1 to 9 with the 0 and the boss button delete and enter. The behavior of the delete button is good and you can see the preview for each button. Okay. It worked great. That's all for that tutorial. To discover more tutorials on Android development, don't hesitate to subscribe to the S Sorel channel.